Well, I hope you're ready to break a sweat. A mental sweat, that is. In this sketch titled Move That Derriere, we'll be discussing the inherited blister disease known as Derriere's disease, which is characterized by a number of cutaneous findings involving the skin and hair, as well as neurologic manifestations. Let's get started with our central hook in the form of a Derriere's California sign on the entry to our gym, which has an outline of a Derriere. We chose the California logo because the genetic defect results in a dysfunctional calcium transporter. Speaking of, let's talk about the basic science and histology you need to know regarding Derriere's disease. We'll show these features on the left-hand side of the sketch in the children's play area. Oh, how bougie. Kids love this place because of the teeter-totter and toys. This teeter-totter with the fulcrum shaped like an A with our recurring two swan toys on each side should remind you that the defective calcium transporter is specifically the ATP2A2 gene, which encodes the SERCA2, or CERCA2, transporter. CERCA is an acronym for Smooth Endoplasmic Reticulum Calcium Transporter 2. Compare this to Hailey-Hailey disease, which is due to ATP2C1. The end result is defective calcium sequestration within the endoplasmic reticulum, manifesting with impaired cell adhesion due to acantholysis. Recall from basic science that calcium is needed in order for processing of junctional proteins, such as desmoplakin and E-cadherin. We'll remind you of acantholysis with our recurring dilapidated bricks, in the form of play blocks, here on the ground. While acantholysis is seen on histology, it's only a minor finding. More notable is dyskeratosis, which can be seen as core rods and core grains, which literally mean round bodies and grain bodies. To signify this, we've drawn these round balls and a box of whole grain cereal spilled on the floor for core rods and core grains, respectively. All right, let's kick this mental workout into double time and talk about the clinical features of Derriere's, which will be shown on the gym floor. You'll notice a sign on the wall in the play area which reads drop of 20 or less. This is to remind you that the clinical findings almost always manifest prior to age 20. Specifically, these patients develop verrucous-crusted red papules in a seborrheic distribution, with a foul odor resulting from the maceration and secondary infection, not unlike the smelly sweat stains on our first gym-goer who is positioned away from us. Notice how the sweat stains are in a seborrheic distribution, and he has green smelly wavelines. In addition to reminding you of the distribution, his excessive sweating should remind you that heat, friction, and sweat are exacerbating factors and should try to be avoided. By the way, this is a great time for my PSA. If you can't see the smelly guy in your gym, well, you might be the smelly guy. All right, back to it. Our second guy has the right idea. It's all about getting swole with resistance training. He's going to represent the nail and mucosal findings associated with Derriere's disease. I want to draw your attention to the bar and weights for the cable machine that he's using. First, notice how the bar is shaped like an acute angle, kind of like a V. This V-shaped bar that he's gripping is to remind you of the V-nicking of the nails, while the fancy red and white staggered weights should be a reminder of the red and white longitudinal lines of the nails, which are sometimes described as candy cane lines. These features like to show up on boards, so be sure to go look at some clinical photos of these features. He must really be working hard because it looks like he's giving a good grunt. His mouth being open is to remind you that mucosal lesions are seen in these patients, specifically cobblestoning of the oral mucosa, most commonly the hard palate. We've added this cobblestone-esque mat that he's standing on as a hook for this. We'll discuss the last of the cutaneous features with our female character in the center of the sketch. Notice how she's carrying and gripping a bag, and her bag is losing all of this debris. This debris on the ground is a recurring hook for palmar plantar keratoderma, but you might also notice that there are some holes in the floor by her. Man, these dumb guys, always dropping weights. See, this is why we can't have nice things. These holes should serve to remind you that Derriere's is on the differential for palmar plantar pits. I think this lady is probably a little too glamorous to be hanging around all these smelly guys. I mean, she's got maybe 4-5 carats worth of jewels on her hands. These large jeweled rings are to remind you of a commonly tested finding called acrokeratosis verusiformis of Hopf, which manifests with numerous flat-topped papules located on the dorsal hands. While dermatologists are most likely to be concerned with the cutaneous findings, you should know that these patients do have more serious complications to be aware of, and we'll show these in the back right of the sketch with our guy on the treadmill. One of the most feared complications is called Kaposi's variceiliform eruption, which is a secondary infection of the affected areas with HSV. Our recurrent hook for HSV is a Hermes-like headband, like our runner is wearing right here. You know this guy is fit because he's super holistic. Just look at that sweet bipolar magnet he's holding to cure his ailments. This bipolar magnet is our recurrent hook for bipolar disorder, and Darier patients are at an increased risk for neuropsychiatric illness, such as depression, bipolar disorder, and schizophrenia. Of note, a common treatment for bipolar disorder is lithium. In patients with Darier's, lithium should not be used, because it will worsen the cutaneous manifestations. These patients are also at higher risk for seizure disorders, which should be evident by this exceptionally healthy advertising for our recurring seizure Caesar salads here on the back wall. Now I know you're craving your post-workout smoothie already, but we're not done here yet. Last thing we need to do is discuss treatment options, which are shown in the back left. The first line is generally topical steroids, shown with our refreshing hydrocooler water bottles. However, the majority of cases will require more aggressive systemic therapy. In these cases, systemic retinoids are 90% effective as shown by our high-octane energy drink. Note that topical retinoids can be beneficial as well, but the irritation they produce may limit the patient's adherence to the plan. Additionally, patients with a predominance of bullous lesions often report worsening with oral retinoids, and this should be taken into consideration. Another treatment option if they're unable to tolerate a retinoid is methotrexate. In derm mnemonics, we use a T-Rex anytime we want you to think of methotrexate. In this sketch, we've chosen to make a pretty cool T-Rex scooter for the kids to play on. While not explicitly shown, it should be pretty self-evident that patients with a chronically disrupted skin barrier are at a high risk of secondary infections. Because of this, they should be using some sort of topical antimicrobial such as chlorhexidine or benzoyl peroxide wash in addition to topical antibiotics such as mupirocin or clindamycin. Topical keratolytic agents are also beneficial for removing scale and reducing irritation. Okay, the workout is over, time for the cool down. We're gonna wrap this up with a quick review of the hooks. This sketch is covering Darier's disease, as shown by our Darier's sign. The CA is to remind you that this is a calcium transporter, specifically CIRCA, which is encoded by ATP2A2 and shown by the teeter-totter with the A fulcrum and two swan toys. This manifests with acantholysis, our dilapidated blocks, but more important to recognize is the dyskeratosis seen as core rods and core grains, shown with the round balls and whole grain cereal. The clinical features are generally present by the age 20 and manifest as pruritic, odorous papules in a seborrheic distribution, so recall the less than 20 drop-off sign and our first gym goer with a smelly sweat marks in a seborrheic distribution. Recall that this should remind you that sweat, heat, and friction are also exacerbating factors. Other features include nail, mucosal, and palmar plantar findings, which are shown by the man on the cable machine and the woman. The cable machine handle is V-shaped for V-nicking of the nails, the weights are alternating red and white for the red and white longitudinal lines on the nails, and the cobblestone mat is for cobblestoning of the oral mucosa. Recall the debris from the girl's bag and the holes in the floor to remember PPK and palmar pits. Also recall that these patients can have more serious complications, such as Kaposi's variceliform eruption, secondary to HSV, psychiatric conditions such as bipolar disorder and depression, and seizures by remembering the hooks in the back right of the sketch. Namely our runner with his Hermes herpes headband holding a bipolar magnet and the seizure Caesar salad sign on the wall. Remember that bipolar patients should avoid lithium as a mood stabilizer due to risk of exacerbating their skin condition. The treatments for Darier's are on the back left. Topical corticosteroids can be used for treatments of pruritus and mild cases, but the majority of patients will require systemic therapy. The best choice is probably a systemic retinoid and usually results in a 90% effective rate, but there are a wide array of treatment options reported in the literature, including methotrexate. We've included a high-octane energy drink to remind you of retinoids, a T-Rex scooter for methotrexate, and hydrocooler water bottles for topical corticosteroids. Because this is a popular topic for boards and there are a number of variants, details, and treatment options, be sure to take the quiz for some additional information and reinforce your knowledge. Now, go shake that derriere and we'll catch you next time. Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your booty. Shake your booty.